today because he's in for a tough match with Mark Williams.
And just as he did against Rocket Ronnie in the previous round, Wilson is breaking new ground today. He's never played Mark Williams before. Two snooker legends back to back. So if he does make the semi-finals, he'll certainly have earned it. But he's already proved he's a big match player.
Thank you.
Having won his maiden ranking title in Shanghai last year. Already a runner-up this year in India.
Yes, his long potting yesterday against Ronnie O'Sullivan was quite superb. And as Ronnie said in the commentary there, he took the game to him, he attacked, and it paid off. But those long balls have got to go in for that to work.
Bit of housekeeping from Williams as he plays his first shot of the match.
Years of practice. What a judge. Had it gone in, would have been an easy starter. Mark Williams. His safety play in the early part of the match with Ronnie O'Sullivan yesterday was brilliant, as was Ronnie's. Williams got lots of experience.
And the Welshman's match play this week has been rock solid. Not necessarily been knocking in huge breaks, but he's just shown a lot of application. He's potted the key balls when he's had to. He's played a very tight strategic game as well, and as we know, his calm, cool demeanour under pressure is legend. That's why he's achieved as much as he has in the game. It was interesting, Joe, wasn't it, to hear him talk about his career ahead of this match just now in our feature here on Eurosport, and just remind ourselves of how much he has achieved.
Yes, and something that I didn't know about the four events, four BBC events that he won in the first in that year. Well, he got accredited with the top three. Well, that's some record, isn't it?
Well, given the players he was competing against, the holy trinity of Williams, O'Sullivan and Higgins, all at their peak at that time. Hendry, of course, was still a major force in the late 90s, early noughties. Not thrilled with that one, though.
Well, that was well short of the black cushion, wasn't it? That was a nervy safety shot. Yeah, and that wasn't an easy red. He knew he was leaving reds on, had he missed it, but stayed absolutely still on the shot. So first chance falls to Karen Wilson.
Eight.
He's a very likable guy, Karen Wilson. He has an inbuilt confidence, a self-belief about him, but it never crosses the line into arrogance. And you need that self-belief to make it at the very highest level. All the greats have had it. He showed he wasn't intimidated by the prospect of playing O'Sullivan in the previous round, played his own game, went for his shots and didn't panic when Ronnie put 16. Together that sublime run of three centuries in about half an hour. Just stuck to what he'd done in the early frames and it paid off.
Just a moment, please, Karen.
Theo Salbertinger looking after this match today.
Thanks. 23. Sure.
Williams with the loose safety, wondering how expensive that's going to prove to be. Just didn't get the pace.
Yes, this was it. And tried to leave the cue ball on the black cushion there, but very short of pace. Hasn't quite come far enough for this red, but he may be able to open more reds up. And that's really opened things up.
32.
He's not ideal on the yellow or the green. The blue doesn't go to the left corner. So, not as nice as it could have been. Put everything into the pot and kind of left the positional side of the 34. Shot to chance. I'll be disappointed with that one. Played to miss the brown, come further down the table, but even had it missed the brown, it wouldn't have come that far down. Doesn't have to go for this red. Could leave the cue ball on the black cushion. But he's going for it. What a great shot. And not a bad kiss. There was a clever shot that he played 35. There. He was trying to come the other side of the black, which wouldn't have left a red on had he missed the red.
Deadly from distance against O'Sullivan. What a humdinger of a pot that was.
Not out of the woods yet, though. Needs a good pot and position.
Forty-three.
Played for the pink. Pink goes to that left corner.
Forty-nine. 50.
Well, he's underhit that one, but he's got 57. A red to the middle pocket. Well, that didn't work out as planned, but it was the previous shot not getting on the red as he intended. So maybe time to put a colour save. He could play the blue.
Ball.
Yeah, just pushing that blue safe. And trying to hide this red over the right corner pocket. Just giving himself a little bit of insurance there with putting the blue on the cushion. Now, can he pot this? Well, that was close. That was very close. Caught it too thin in the end. So, I don't think he's going to survive this one, Mark Williams.
One.
This black and one more red should suffice for the first frame. Yes, the black ball jumped there. Heavy contact, but no damage done.
It.
Wilson looks at the scoreboard to confirm. He's nearly over the line in this first frame. It was Williams' mistake with the safety shot at the start of the frame that was the real cause of his demise in this opener. Half a chance to get back into it with that long red, but it wasn't to be. No heroics on the black, just make doubly sure.
16. Ken Wilson, 16, enter frame.
Mark Williams remains in his chair with only 59 remaining on the table. So the safety error proving costly for the two times world champion. Kyron Wilson making a break of 58 to take the O'Sullivan with a break of 58 in the opening frame. Mark Williams making an error with a safety. But a long way to go. The first of five today, of course, here in the quarterfinals. Barry Hawkins has already booked his place in the last four with a comfortable win over Michael White. And the winner of this will play the Mark King or the only Iranian professional, Hossein Vafai, who I know that our own Jimmy White rates very highly. Looking forward to seeing him play.
You know, when you say our very own Jimmy White, does that mean we own him?
No, he's too expensive. We're just loaning him.
Now we're Jimmy. Didn't want the kiss on the yellow. A half chance.
One.
So, applause for Mark Williams' first red. He's a little heavy, needs a good kiss, and he got it.
Four.
That was a real stroke of luck because he was really heavy, played for the red directly above the black.
Touching point, Mark. Five.
It was a surprisingly straightforward win for Williams over the informed John Higgins. 4-1, Higgins, well, I guess he had to lose sooner or later after his fantastic run of late back-to-back tournaments, but Williams played very solidly, as he's done throughout the tournament.
12.
He's overdue a big title, the last 13. Of those 18 ranking crowns coming a full 5 years ago at the German Masters. Playing well enough to end that barren 20. Run.
Twenty-eight.
Well, he did so well to get there from that black because it was nearly straight.
36.
But it's important that he leaves an angle on either the black or the blue to be able to bring more reds into play after this shot. Preferably the blue, I would think. Nope, playing for the black. And has the angle on the black to go into them.
37.
Well, not as much angle as what I thought.
44.
Had to come off the side cushion.
Mark Williams, 44.
But a nice 44 break. That will settle him down a little. Yes, you can see the reds, but there's no path back to balk. So just trying to land up into them. looking at the possibility of a plant. Oh, what an attacking shot. Didn't know where the cue ball was going, but what an attacking shot that was from Kyron. There was danger. Cue ball was going into the reds. Now, does he drop the yellow in, play the long red, or just
green ball?
Try and trickle up behind the green?
Foul. Kyron Wilson 1, well, Mark Williams 4.
That must have drifted away from the green. He played that three-quarter ball just to land up, and the cue ball must have drifted to the right. We may get a chance to see that again in a moment. But it cost him the snooker. There it is again. Played it very slowly. The cue ball just moved to the right. Let's hope it doesn't upset him mentally. Caught that one too thick. Probably still thinking about that failed snooker attempt. So much of this game's played in the mind. And you can tell that just by the shot that he just played.
One.
That's the worst safety shot he's played in two matches.
Had he laid the snooker as expected, he'd have had control of the table and the chance to hit back in this frame. As it is, Williams now has the opportunity to win it. Already 49 points to the good. 48, of course, with Wilson's single red before the error on the green.
Nine. 16.
This red and one more black.
17.
And it's going to be honors even after two frames.
Twenty-four. Twenty-five. Thirty-one. Thirty-two.
'Yes, he seems to be queuing very well, Mark Williams.
38.
So it's looking like this is going to be a very good match indeed. Both players playing at the top of the form.
Williams would be the first to admit that there have been periods of his career when he hasn't slaughtered himself on the practice table. And indeed, he admitted
45
in the build-up to this match that quite recently
46.
He'd not really been working on his game in the way he might have done, but recently he has, and it looks to be paying dividends.
52.
Yes, you can never write somebody off.
53.
As good as what Mark Williams is.
54.
If he puts the work in, who's to say he can't do what John Higgins has done and Ronnie O'Sullivan.
He has that ability to make this very complex and difficult game look
59.
Very easy when he's in full flow.
61.
Fuss-free snooker.
64.
And that iron temperament to go with it, which has been the bedrock of his success since he 68. Turned professional nearly a quarter of a century ago.
73.
And that's perhaps the most impressive thing about that class of 92.
73.
Sullivan, Williams, Higgins, their longevity, their ability to stay at the top of the game for so long.
79.
Transcending generations. And still very much in the ascendancy. As Williams is proving here, he still has a great chance of moving into the semi-finals at the Northern Ireland Open. In the meantime, he's levelled his quarter-final with Karen Wilson.
What's the break?
Encouraging start to this eagerly awaited quarter-final here at the Northern Ireland Open. A break of 58 from Karen Wilson in the first frame. And breaks a 44 and an 86 clearance from Williams to level at one apiece. So both require four more to go through to the last four tomorrow. Battle is joined.
Yes, but it might not have been an 86 had Karen led that snooker behind the green. He got in with a great plant, very attacking shot. And here comes another one, I think. Great pot. And that little rub on the blue
once
just took him off position on the next colour.
He's already 3 out of 4 from long range in this match. We know how good his long potting was against Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Karen Wilson won.
He was a little wary about hitting that one too slow. Finished up hitting it too hard. He's allowed Mark Williams to see this red on the right side cushion. Although can't do much with it. Can't get back up the table from it. Could have done that cue ball being a little closer to the cushion. Oh, that was so close. I thought it was in at one stage.
One of the best of all time, isn't he, from long range, Williams? We've talked about how good Karen Wilson has been with his long potting. None better than Williams, but this time just failed to drop.
Thank you.
Well, caught that one all wrong. And just struggling at the moment now, Callum Wilson. His last three shots haven't been close enough to the cushion on his safety. And that return of safety caught the red much too thick.
One.
Didn't want the pink to spot on the blue spot.
Seven.
That's tied things up, kind of. The black may be available to the right corner, but there's a red blocking it going into the left corner.
Eight.
Yes, he didn't pot the green in the pocket where he intended. Hence the cue ball hitting 11. The jaws of that middle pocket. Massive kick.
12.
But I think he's on the blue. Look at how high the red jumped. Yes, it's one of those times where the kick probably did him a favour. Because I'm pretty sure he was playing for the green.
17. Twenty-four. 25.
Well, again, he's caught the knuckle, played for the two reds into the left centre. Potted the pink badly,
31.
So the cue ball's come back and hit that middle pocket bump. He's got a thin red to the left corner, but this is not what he wanted.
Eight.
looking at the red to the middle. It's a good recovery shot, but it needs to slow down.
32.
Well, it just kept running and running. May be able to pot the blue, but the cue ball could be going into the brown.
It's been hard work this break, but Williams has somehow managed to keep it going.
34.
Well, again, that wiped its feet as well. But the main thing is, it dropped.
41. Fifty-five.
So another red and a colour. And that should put Williams safe in this game.
56.
Applause for frame ball.
62.
Yes, it's not been straightforward by any means. And once or twice, it looked as though Williams might break down, but no.
63.
He's come through for his second straight frame.
Well, I said it in the last frame, he's cueing so well. This is the old Mark Williams that we're watching here. He said he'd put the hard work in. Looks like he's reaping the dividends.
68.
Might just be able to clip the black in the middle.
68 into frame.
Kyron Wilson remains seated. He's potted just two balls in the last two frames since taking the opener. And he's never been quite the same since failing to lay the snooker behind the green. Williams, 2-1 up. Frame and open for a place in the semi-finals. Wilson started well with a break of 58. But Mark Williams has shown just why he is a multiple World UK and Masters winner. He's in stroke, breaks of 44, 86 and 68 just now to win frames 2 and 3. Wilson has left one out off the break.
And Williams has duly popped it in. Needed another couple of inches one. Bounce off the cue, that cue ball off the black cushion there. Black is still available, but a lot tougher. Nicely played. And that was a shot from a confident man.
Who's been monopolising the table in the last couple of frames. He struck a nice rhythm here, Williams, and that makes him very dangerous.
Didn't really get enough side on the cue ball. Wanted to be straighter on 60. This red, so I'm going to have to go down for the blue.
17.
But as long as it's the right side of it, it's okay.
Three spells at world number one Mark Williams has enjoyed. At one point, he was in danger of dropping out of the top 32. He was even talking retirement. That was several years ago now.
Yes.
But he returned right to the very top of the game. He got his mojo 29. Back, started to practice hard again. And in winning the German Masters back in 2011, that helped carry him back to the top of the summit. How he would love to book his place once again at the Masters. He's on the cusp at the moment in the rankings with this tournament and, of course, the UK coming up next week. The qualifying events to determine the 16 players who will do battle at Ali Pali in the new year. Wouldn't be the same without him, would it, Joe?
Well, absolutely. One of the all-time greats. He's faced with a tough pink here, though. He looks too high. So, a half chance.
Mark Williams, 33.
For Kyron Wilson. And those are the kind of shots that you never used to miss. Just dropping them into the pocket. It could be costly.
245 points to two. Over the last two and a quarter frames in Williams' favour, can Wilson re-establish some rhythm?
Well, I struck that nicely. One. There is a red that will go in that cluster to the same corner or to the middle. Wants to get rid of this red to the left corner first, because the black will then go in both pockets.
Nine.
Big frame this, and if you can punish Mark Williams for that missed pink, it'll give him something to think about in the interval. Well, needs to put everything into the pot
16.
Here because it's not guaranteed. Might just be able to open the reds a little with the pink over the middle. Doesn't have to worry about position. Good pot,
17.
And that's opened everything up. Felt he had to go into them. Red would go to the right corner, just dropping it in with a touch 24. Of side. Hasn't worked out. Red is cuttable. And the other red is cuttable to the right corner too. Maybe able to go back and have a look at the split that he just made a moment ago and see that there were reds available. Didn't have to go into them. And this is a tough one. Good pot. There's always going to be on the pink.
25.
And with the red just above the blue, maybe worthwhile playing the pink.
The pink that Williams missed just now when he was on a break of 33 and looking to carve out a 3-1 interval lead.
Lots of right-hand side on the cue ball to check it back down the table, but once the pink is re-spotted.
31.
Again, he just got too much speed in the cue ball there. Feel sure he played for the red to the left middle. So needs another good pot. And can take it to the middle or the corner. And that's another good pot. That really was a great recovery shot. Those are the kind of shots that win your matches, win your tournaments.
All the evidence suggests that Wilson possesses a very impressive match play temperament. Backs himself, isn't afraid to attack, even if there is some risk involved. Willing to speculate, to accumulate. And this is a very big frame, the difference between being 3-1 adrift and level pegging.
Well, that wasn't a good positional shot, that, again.
45.
He's put himself under pressure again. A little heavy. Does this red next to the pink go
49.
To the middle? Just having a look to see if the pink will go. Could play for the pink this time round. Ideal on the black, just to drop it in, play that red into the middle. If not, then he'll have to play the cannon. And hopefully, if he does play that, he plays it to the pink. Now the red goes. And to say that he sat out the last two frames,
57.
This has been an excellent visit to the table from Kieron Wilson.
An ice cool break, and he needs
58.
Just the pink to level this match at the interval. What an entertaining mini session it's been. Both players looking really good when they're in amongst them.
59.
The crowd know that was the significant ball of this break.
64.
And Wilson has punished Williams for his error on the pink to right centre.
Yes, and he's knocked in some 66. Good balls to keep it going as well, which will do his confidence a world of good.
'69.
58 from Wilson in the opener. Largely frozen out in the next two. 44, 86 and 68 from Williams.
73.
So a great response from the former Shanghai Masters champion. Such a pure ball striker, isn't he?
Oh, fantastic blow. And look at the side on the cue ball there.
84.
This to register the best break of the match so far. And what a contribution it was, and what a match we have on our hands. So after four frames, it's as you were, the spoil shared. Terrific entertainment for this Belfast crowd. It's two apiece and good stuff. Somewhat under the radar this week in Mark King, another veteran. Still playing at a good level into his 40s, so that's coming up later this evening. As, of course, is the home favourite, Mark Allen, against Anthony Hamilton. Allen falling over the line somewhat in that epic post-midnight battle with Gary Wilson.
Caught it a touch thick.
Six from long range for Wilson so far today.
One of the more straightforward long pots that Wilson has sunk today. That's 6 out of 7 now from distance.
Five.
Yes, good pop, but would have liked that cue ball just a fraction harder. I think the black will go to this left corner. Having to send the cue ball all the way around the table. And just got past the blue spot. Coming round to have a look at the black.
10.
I think it will go to the left corner. And if he can finish a little low on the black, there's confirmation. He can play the cannon to the two reds just above it. So this is an important shot that he's playing here.
Yeah.
Just needs to finish a little low. Can he pot the black? Yes, looks like he can get it from there. Would have liked to have been the other side of it, though, to play the cannon.
Five. 18.
Well, this time he made sure he was low, but that's a little too low. Still on it, still should pot it. But the positional side, not guaranteed. Nicely played, and he's on a red to the left corner.
26. Thirty-five.
Well, decided to play the cannon. And if the red next to the pink goes,
50,
then it's no problem. And now he's done all the hard work. He's got to make sure he finishes the job.
57. 58.
He was 2-1 down, and Mark Williams missed a pink to the right middle when he was going so well. Made a great clearance, and he's got his mojo back.
65.
Another very clean frame in this quarter-final. Both players scoring heavily when they get the chance.
65. Yes, what I like about it is that both players are trying to win and not
66.
Relying on the safety. This time it was a poor safety from Mark Williams. That pink was frame ball.
72.
Punch and counter punch so far. A really enjoyable match.
79.
The only thing missing has been a century thus far. That could change now.
Yeah, delightful little cannon he played there, bringing the red off the cushion. Everything available now.
87.
That extraordinary qualifying match for the China Open earlier this year. Kyron Wilson with Anthony Hamilton, who of course has also made the quarterfinals. They made six centuries. Wilson carved out four of them.
94. 95.
seems to be getting quicker. Oh, well.
Kyle Wilson, 95.
A great shame. He deserved a century. It was a terrific break. Once again, clinically punishing Mark Williams' loose safety to edge back in front for the first time. The best of the match, very nearly a century, to take him 3-2 in front and two away from the semi-finals.
Well, once again, he's left that little tempter there down the right side of the table, but he's got a good cue ball. And of course, Williams didn't want to go 4-2 down. Has to get past the middle pocket, which I think it's just about done. Oh, what a great pot. Trouble is, he got the cue ball where he wanted it. And as Ronnie O'Sullivan was saying, he's one of the best in the world at rolling up behind the ball.
Williams, one.
Those are difficult shots, and he just tickles in behind them. He will have left it short in his career at some stage, but more often than not, it's a good snooker.
He's always been about touch, hasn't he, Williams? He's not someone who bludgeons the ball around. He likes to just stroke the balls in, and I think that helps with those delicate little shots that he plays on the bought colours when he's laying a snooker.
One.
Could have done with just a little bit more pace. It, the cue ball. But played that one well. That was another delightful little shot he played there.
Eight. Nine.
It's a pleasure to watch this, isn't it, Joe? Both players just looking in such 60. Good rhythm when they're in.
Yeah, exactly. And that black you just potted there, you know, those are missable. But right in the heart 17. Of the pocket, potted it so smoothly.
Twenty-five.
You can see why he's been double world champion and world number one. Although he's overrun that one a little. Well, he's a little unfortunate there. He had no choice but to go into the reds, try and leave himself
32.
On one, but they've all covered one another. That looks to be end of break.
Deja vu for Williams, who broke down on a break of 33 in the fourth frame when he was looking good for a 3-1 interval lead. Ended up having to share the spoils.
Well, this red goes to the left corner. So not as bad as we once thought. Good recovery.
33.
Could easily have overcut that, but in it goes.
Well, again, he potted the yellow badly there, and that's why he's out of position.
35.
Out of ideal position. Wanted to be straighter on this red to the right corner. Got a little bit too much left-hand side on the cue ball. But another good recovery, and another good couple of kisses.
36.
Well, if you bought a ticket today,
43.
You've been treated to a great exhibition of snooker.
44.
Which isn't an exhibition, it's pure match play. Made to look like an exhibition.
Fifty-two.
Now, it doesn't need to go into that cluster of four. As we look at the shot time, 16 seconds. Ronnie O'Sullivan standard.
59. I think that's a measure of how good the positional play has been.
59.
The cue ball, more often than not, exactly where these two players have wanted it. They haven't had to think too much when they've been in amongst the reds. Everything has flowed very freely.
Thanks.
Well, those stats are off the scale. I mean, that is tremendous. Karen Wilson
60.
Has missed just two balls in the match. Williams only five. And one of the two that Wilson missed was to pot the black for the century just now, so
67.
It was hardly crucial.
Well, that black was frame
68.
Ball, and that just makes sure.
Mark well, Williams, 68.
Williams has almost certainly done enough. Kyron Wilson requires three snookers, but he's coming back.
Well, one. You just never know, do you? You know, a snooker with a free ball, you just never know. And it's good to see.
Eight. Time.
And the red next to the pink is in a guaranteed place to leave a good snooker. Now it's important he positions the white here so he can send the red down the table, preferably next to a colour, so there's a chance of a free ball.
24.
That's tight. That's tight.
Karen Wilson, 24.
Now, if he should miss the red and leave the cue ball in the balk area, it could be a chance of a free ball. But what he should be saying to himself is, whatever happens, don't leave a free ball.
A good hit from one cushion by Williams. Sometimes tricky to judge.
Sounded a bit kicky. Well, just got to be careful here. If he comes down the table, the in-off is on. Better going across the table. Less chance of the in-off.
A bit more and he'd have potted the red. And that would have been frame over for short.
Well, felt he had no choice but to pot the red. So imperative that this black goes in. But then he would need three snookers.
A tall order indeed.
Eight. Karen Wilson, eight.
Well, half a chance here of getting the cue ball in behind the black. Well, that should be enough of this frame. Can't see Karen coming back out of his chair now.
Mark Williams, two. Enter frame.
And sure enough, Karen Wilson gives a nod of the head to say, yep, I've had enough of that frame. So still nothing to choose between this pair. They're both scoring very heavily. Always promised to be so. Two players in top form. Mark Williams, who's been there and done it all before, of course. Karen Wilson, still in the very embryonic stages of his career, albeit that he's already a ranking titleist. And the breaks have flowed from the cues of both men. Wilson with 58, 91 and 95. Williams, 86 and a brace of 68 breaks, including the one just now for three all.
The red on the right side cushion causing a little bit of a problem for Mark Williams. But caught that one nice. Well, he'll be delighted with that. He was in a bit of trouble there. Looking at that three ball plant to the left corner. And it looks close, this. And in it goes. Now, where's that cue ball going to finish?
One.
Well, he's on the yellow, but it's a little straight. Can he get down the table from the yellow? He's not scared of taking these plants on, is he? Well, he won't be happy with that one.
Three.
He did well to get the cue ball down that far the table, but he's not in a good position there. May have to play the safety. He's looking at this thin red to the left corner, but I don't know how he could avoid the reds if he plays that shot. These two have been going for anything and everything, and invariably they've been going in. Well, this red by the pink goes to the right corner, just, and it's in. Needs a good kiss, and he got one. Deserved one.
Four.
What a terrific shot that was. Very missable. Again, Wilson benefiting from his positive attacking approach to the game.
Seven. Eight.
The black goes to the left corner. Pink's also free. And that's just where he wants to be, for the pink or black.
13.
Indicative of just how evenly matched these players have been today. They've both produced a very high standard. Neither has been fazed by the other's ability. It's not been far off one chance snooker. Wilson, keep that trend going here.
27.
Just a little shorter pace this time. Could have played for the pink to the right corner. Chose to play for the blue. Well, I'm not sure if he played for this red. But he's on it, and it's not a gimme. Played it well.
Looks very accomplished with the rest, doesn't he?
34.
Yeah, got nicely on the pink. The two reds to the right of the pink will go into this same left corner. I thought he might have come back across the table. Had he not finished on those two reds, it'd have been
40
on that red closest to the right corner pocket. As long as he keeps putting these balls, it's okay.
A
slight grimace and a shake of the head from Wilson. Still some way to go before he can think about clinching this frame. A frame that will put him within one of the semi-finals.
40 that cue ball just to come back another couple of inches. Being straight on this red.
47.
But it's okay, can still pot it. Another confident 48.
Pot. 54.
Still needs a couple of reds, at least one colour. And he's got the angle on the pink to screw back for this red to the right of the black. Well, what a good break this has been by Kyron Wilson. Wasn't straightforward. He's had to work for it.
61.
But this red should seal this seventh frame.
If you were putting together a highlights 62. Reel of this match, you'd be hard pushed to do much editing. It's been terrific.
3 snookers 69. Needed from Williams.
Can he be
Kyron
tempted?
Wilson, 69.
After a little bit of thought, the answer is yes, no. Cue on the table. And from Kyron Wilson, it's a case of anything you can do, Mark. Break of 68 from Williams in the previous Wilson. Who has the frame advantage? He needs just one. Williams needs two. Just a reminder that, of course, we've got another quarter-final coming up later on this evening. Our coverage, as usual, starting at 6:45. We're building up to the home favourite. The left-hander from Antrim, Mark Allen, against the veteran, the Sheriff of Pottingham, as he used to be known, Anthony Hamilton, who's been involved in a couple of Ben Hur-style epics already. And you wouldn't bet against another one.
So he's not known by that anymore, then. The Sheriff of Pottingham.
Sheriff of Safetydom.
He's a terrific break builder.
He certainly is.
Yes, and that red going down the table now. Stop the orthodox safety play.
Came very close to knocking or being knocked out yesterday, Hamilton, by Yanbing Tao, the teenager from China who won the World Cup, of course. Hamilton having to win the penultimate frame of that match on the final black before taking the decider. Had that very late night affair with Ken Doherty, which finished at 2:15 in the morning. So he's battle hardened for sure. And Mark Allen hasn't yet hit top form, has he, Joe? So it's not necessarily a foregone conclusion for Allen that match.
No, he's struggling with his form, but that's a sign of a good player when he struggles with his form and wins. Well, Williams having a real good look at the red that's over that left middle pocket. He thinks he can pot it. If he can, he can bring the cue ball back down the table for the black or the pink.
He also knows if he does go for it and misses, it could be his final shot of this tournament.
Yes, and also the safety could be the final shot of the tournament for him. Because although he's got the safety with this red over on the left side of the table, there's danger with it. Now, he could take this red on to the right middle. It's a tough pot.
Well, you're not kidding. Goodness me.
Well, considered it for a second. I think if the pink went into the left middle, he might have played it.
Someone's going to make hay. Who's going to get in?
Well, the cue ball not quite dead, so he could dig down into the cue ball, try and play that red that's nearest the left side cushion, and try and get that cue ball in back in behind the black. But it's a tough shot. And that's the shot he's playing. Didn't quite get into the cue ball as he wanted, and he's left a half chance to the middle.
Nope.
And now, Kyron with a chance to the right middle.
A look of annoyance and indeed concern spreads over the face of Williams.
What a big shot this is. But it could be the winner.
One.
It's down to him now, and he hasn't missed much.
Just three balls in the whole match, to be precise, and at least one of those was academic in terms of the outcome of the frame.
Didn't get the cannon on the red that he played.
Eight.
And when he thinks about it, he didn't need to play the cannon if he'd have gone past that red, which is what he might have played.
A gilt-edged chance to claim frame and match has just got a good deal harder.
Yeah, he's knocked in some good long reds. Can he knock in another one?
None more pressure than this one. Knowing what he'll leave if it stays out.
Karen Wilson.
Next. Yes, he knew he was leaving reds on.
So Mark Williams gets another chance.
One.
Didn't he's pop just, that cleanly, did he?
No, he just lost the cue ball, didn't he? And just have to play the snooker.
Mark Williams.
Both of these players have looked cucumber cool throughout this match, but suddenly we're getting towards the business end and perhaps the nerves, the tension, pressure is beginning to rise, as it so often does.
Well, this is big, big trouble.
Finding a safe spot on the table is going to take quite some doing here for Kyron.
Well, he's looking to land up to that red closest to the right middle pocket.
Foul in the miss. Mark Williams,
oh
six.
Dear.
Yeah, I don't think that's going back. He's got various reds he can play. There's one over the ball corner. That's guaranteed. Just spotted it in time. He had the rest out for the difficult red to the right corner.
One.
So another chance for Mark Williams.
Yes, and with so many options available to him, this is a test of concentration as much as skill. Making sure
five.
There are no silly positional mistakes.
Six.
It's a great opportunity to take us all the way to a ninth and deciding frame.
Eight. Nine. 13. Twenty. 21.
He looks high. It always looked high.
Mark Williams, 21.
He's blocked the pocket with the red below the pink, but the red next to the blue will go. It always looked a little high. So, Kyron Wilson gets another chance. Another big shot. Yes, the nerves are beginning to take the toll. And if the red passes the green, that was a poor positional shot. He could have screwed the cue ball back to the cushion for safety. He'd have been on the black.
One. Five. Six.
The red. Kyron missed, and will he get another chance? He's over hit it. He's over hit it. Has a red to the bot corner, but he wanted these easy reds to the right corner. This is missable again.
We've seen more mistakes in this frame than we saw in the previous seven combined, indicative of what a crucial stage this quarter final has reached.
This is a tough red with the rest. It was never easy. Now, how's your luck?
Mark Williams.
I think he's
13.
Left the red on. So, Kyron Wilson, he gets another chance.
33, Mark Williams lead. But still plenty there for Wilson to deny him a final frame.
Well, he's left an angle on the green to bring that red by the middle pocket into play, if he so wishes. It's risky to play that shot. May not finish on the red. So easy to play down for these three that do go. He's played the cannon, and he's got it well. He needed it at some stage. That was a brave shot to play.
Four.
Yes, courage is not something that Kyron Wilson lacks. And that's bound to prove a big asset in the years ahead as he builds his career. He's got a great temperament, inner self-belief, and bags a bottle. A pretty persuasive combination.
10.
Well, he could have played for the red behind the pink there, which would have freed the pink into this pocket. Just a little pacing.
16.
Just 17 points the difference now. And 17. Back in prime position. Come down to that last red. The brown not in the best place, but suits a right-handed player.
Wilson still looking calm, but I'm sure there's a lot going on beneath the surface right now.
Chose to play up for the blue. Easier to get to the red from, but he's not ideal on the blue. Could even play the cannon to the red from the blue. He's got choices.
This shot might just determine the outcome of this frame and match.
12. He couldn't have played it any better. He's got a good angle on the red to stun the cue ball out for one of these 26. Ball colours. And he'll be pinning all his hopes on this red, Mark Williams. Oh, he couldn't have played that one any better either.
27.
Rueful smile from Kyron Wilson. It's not getting any easier, but he is edging his way towards the semi-finals. Just six behind now.
Yes, a rueful smile because he thinks he got a big bounce off the cushion. He was playing for the green or yellow. So, anything but straight on the green should be okay to get across the table to the brown. I think he's just about got the angle.
Deep breath. This is the key shot. Williams sits and hopes.
He needs it to bounce, and it's not gonna.
37.
Well, if he's going to keep the break going, it's got to be to the green pocket. And what a tough shot that is.
Needs up to and including the pink to be sure.
It's there. It's there.
This is some break, by the way. But he's not there yet.
He still needs another good shot, doesn't he? If he pots the blue, Mark Williams can only tie. So it's a big shot, this. It was a massive shot. Now, where's it going to finish? Not good for Karen Wilson.
Karen Wilson, 41.
Well, he put everything into that visit to the table. He was so close. But Williams gets a reprieve.
Five.
We're going to a decider.
What a great match this has been. It really has. One of the best of the tournament. We saw the best yesterday, with Kyron Wilson getting the better of Ronnie O'Sullivan in a thriller. And this is just as engrossing.
18.
Wow. One frame shootout for a place in the last four here in Belfast.
Yes, I just wondered if he can get that blue out of his mind, because that was a chance to win. He was on the pink. Can he get that shot out of his mind?
He's been potting these for fun all week. He went for it. Pressure, though, now at its greatest. Who's going to handle it better?
Well, Mark Williams has been in this situation many, many times in big events. So you would say that is slight favourite. Well, the first one, that leaves a touching ball. Leaves an easy escape. Well, he might be able to play the cue ball down the table. Use the brown to hide that red. Oh, he was some way away from that one. So it's going to be Wilson that gets the first chance in this decider. What he wouldn't do for a 78, 90 break here. And he's knocked in plenty of big breaks in this match so far. A couple of 90s, 69, 58. Well, if there's any doubt whatsoever about that black not spotting, should play for the other red. The one to the right corner, and that way is guaranteed to be on a red. Had he played for the one just above the black, could have been out of position.
Nine.
Well, I'm not sure if he played into the pack of reds there. I think he played to come past them.
14.
And that's why he held his hand up. Well, he's 15. On the pink if the black doesn't go. Back in prime position. Chance to settle a little bit more.
Thanks. 21.
Just having a look to see if the pink will pop to that left corner. And judging by that shot, it
22.
Does. So a chance to open the reds up from the pink. Didn't have the angle to open the reds. Mustn't be touching.
28. Twenty-nine. 34.
Well, it would be a brave man that goes into the back of reds with the two loose reds. In fact, he could play for this red to the right corner and try and stay on the pink, and that would be an ideal ball to open the reds from.
Every frame of this match has had at least a 50 break. Quite a few, some way higher than that.
I think he's come a little too high.
41.
Shake of the head would suggest so, certainly. Well, you have to make do with 41.
Well, he might be able to play the cannon to the red by the black. I don't think it goes. Just having a look at that shot now, but... Well, does it go? It's hard to tell from there. He's right behind the shot. And he's not sure.
And if you're not sure, in a final frame decider for a place in a major semi-final, you surely err on the side of caution.
Well, he thinks it goes. He's got an easy safety to skim off the reds.
Very handy lead in a final frame of 47 points. Same scenario for referee Selbertinger. With the pink spot still occupied.
Yes. 47.
He's looked at that quite a few times now, and I don't think he's 100% certain. We're about to find out.
47.
And that's why there was some indecision, and he's left that Ken red.
Wilson, 47.
So Williams gets a chance to try and fight back in this final frame. Kyron Wilson with a 47-point lead, but there's still many more than that on the table.
Well, decided to go into them straight away. Now, is he on the pink? He's on the blue. And everything available.
There's a bit of pressure on this, though.
Something similar to the blue that Kyron missed. And he's missed it. Well, Mark would
Williams
you believe
won.
It?
Yeah.
It sounded a bit clunky, but maybe Williams didn't cue it as smoothly as he would have done in some of the other frames we've seen. This is a decider. It's a different situation. Pressure is so much greater.
Well, maybe he got a kick, and that is so, so unfortunate. Because I kind of fancied him to win, clear up, and win the frame of match there.
Well, he didn't hesitate, did he, in splitting the reds? But what a chance now for Kyron Wilson. Already 47 points in front.
One.
Now with that red, but more importantly, the reds available to clinch frame a match.
Two. 8. Nine.
This black and one more red is all that's required to put Wilson into the semi-finals.
Well, it's been a really fabulous match 16. To watch, full of terrific break building. We've seen some drama at the back end as well. Cameron Wilson, a blue 17. Ball away in the previous frame from victory. Mark Williams had a chance to get back into this decider, but that pressure blue, perhaps not helped by a bad contact, stayed out. And Cameron Wilson
22.
Now looks home and dry, barring something very surprising. What a couple of days he's had, knocking out the Rocket Ronnie O'Sullivan yesterday in a fantastic match. This one has been, in its own way, every bit as good.
Okay.
And Mark Williams offers his 29. Hand. He's seen enough. 29. That was a terrific battle. Williams will be very disappointed to have lost, having played so well. But Cameron Wilson is delighted. You saw that little clench of the fist. That's what it means to him. The former Shanghai Masters champion has the chance of another major title here in Belfast. He's through.